वेलकम बैक टू द सेशन। राइट, सो इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट मेटालिक कोटिंग्स, इन दैट स्पेशली गैल्वनाइजेशन व्हिच कम्स अंडर हॉट डिपिंग। सो व्हाई इट इज हॉट डिपिंग मींस वी आर सपोज टू डिप द मेटल इन हॉट कंडीशन फॉर कोटिंग ऑफ एनी टाइप ऑफ मटेरियल। So here metallic coating means you have to coat metal only on a base metal in hot condition. Hence it is hot dipping. Right, in this hot dipping in our syllabus we have galvanization. So as all of you have studied in your previous or junior classes, it is the process of coating iron or steel sheets with a coat of zinc to prevent from the rusting. So simply I can say, in order to protect the base metal from rusting, we have to coat with the zinc. So this phenomenon is called as galvanization. So in order to carry out this galvanization, initially the article, whatever you take, whether it might be iron, steel or any other type, right? So in the form of a sheet, pipe or wire, whatever it may be, initially it must be cleaned. Right, so for example, if you want to coat a painting to the wall, so initially it has to be rubbed with all the marks and all those things, then only it will be painted. Like this, if you go for the wood polishing also, the carpenter, he is to do with the sandpaper so that all the rough edges and everything will be done smooth, then only the coating will be done. So like this, here also initially, whatever article you are supposed to coat, it must be cleaned. So this cleaning process is called as pickling, right? And moreover, this can be otherwise called as acid pickling, because we are supposed to dip in the acid. Here the acid used is dilute sulfuric acid, right? So of minimum concentration, like around 40%, max 40%, and it must be dipped around 50 to 20 minutes at a temperature maintained of 60 to 90 degrees centigrade. So what is the use of this acid pickling? So acid is a very good cleansing agent, so that it can clean the scale, dirt, oil, grease or rust or any other type of impurities which are being formed on the metal, so that it is going to get rid of all the dirty things. Now the article is free from all the impurities, so hence it is washed well. Then afterwards it must be dried. Afterwards it will be dipped in a bath of molten zinc, maintained at 425 to 430 degrees centigrade. Why should you maintain this much temperature? This is the melting point of the zinc. So in order to coat a metal over a base metal, metal over metal, simply I can say. So you cannot, it cannot be done in dry state. It can be done in the molten state. So initially you have to melt the metal. So, right? So for this, the melting point temperature has to be maintained. And in order to dip this into the molten zinc bath, the surface of the bath is kept covered with ammonium chloride flux. Why should be covered with flux? What is the role of flux here? It prevents the oxide layer formation. So what are the consequences if oxide layer formation will take place? The consequences are, again it undergoes oxidation type of corrosion. So the main scenario or impact, whatever you are going to protect or prevent from corrosion, is going to be wasted again if it undergoes oxidation corrosion. Hence, so before going to coat zinc over the base metal, it must be dipped into the ammonium chloride flux, so simply in order to prevent the oxide formation. Then afterwards, the article is covered with a thin layer of zinc, which will be taken out of the bath. Then later on, it will be passed through a pair of hot rollers. So why it should, why you are supposed to use hot rollers? Do you mean that the zinc, molten layer of zinc, will be stick to the base metal uniformly? No, not at all. Somewhere else it will be higher, somewhere else it will be lower, like that. So, but if the coating has to be done, means it must be done uniformly. So, in order to get uniform thickness of zinc coating over the base metal, it must be passed through the pair of hot rollers so that the excess can be removed. Then afterwards, it will be sent into the annealing and it will be collecting the annealed or galvanized sheet. See, look at this diagram. This is before. These are the materials before hot dipping galvanization process. So this is the fine material. See how it shines when there is no corrosion. There will be no loss of metal. Right? So not only it is going to losing the metal, but also it gives a nice appeal to our eyes. See how nice it is. This is after hot dipping. So what are the uses? This can be done for roofing sheets, vials, pipes, nails, bolts, screws, buckets, chutes, whatnot and whatnot. Of course you can say you can do this for any type of large or bulk articles. So for which preferably we are going to do this for which are made up of iron, because iron is the most useful metal and which undergoes corrosion to the greater extent. Right? So galvanizing prevents to the greater extent. But the main disadvantage is, all these are very good. If you do galvanization, obviously it will be prevented from corrosion and rusting, so that it looks aesthetic appeal, it protects metal from corrosion. All these are very advantages. But one more disadvantage is also there. The thing is, it cannot be used for preparing and storing foodstuffs. So because zinc is toxic in nature, when you are going to cook that one, obviously it forms zinc oxide or zinc acids or whatever it may be, which is very much toxic. Right? So this is about galvanization. Right? So thank you all. See in the next class. So one more topic is left over in this chapter, which is called as electroplating and electroless plating. So that topic is also involved in the protection or prevention from corrosion. Thank you all. See you in the next class.